Hey everybody, it's Alex with Engineering Applied. In this video, I'll be giving you a detailed overview of the Thicken offset tool found in Autodesk Inventor. If you want more easy to understand and practical content like this, made by an experienced engineer like myself, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any helpful content like this in the future. Also, if you're looking for a specific function, check the description for timestamps. And if you don't find what you're looking for in this video, make sure you check out the other videos in the Autodesk Inventor series playlist, because I know you'll find exactly what you need there. Let's get started. Okay, so to demonstrate the Thicken offset tool, I went ahead and drew up half of an electrical enclosure that goes around a printed circuit board. And with this enclosure, what we're going to do is we're going to use the Thicken offset tool to add and take away from the thickness of the inside of this housing. And so this would be a really practical use for this command when we're designing some injection molded parts, and we either have to add to the wall thickness to make this part easier to manufacture or take it away to save a little bit on weight. So let's go ahead and jump into it. Now we'll go up to the modify section and we're going to click Thicken offset. And again, to use this tool, we need some 3D geometry in our design space, which we already have here. So let me move this window over just a little bit. And I'm going to start in the top left hand corner, and I'm going to work my way down into the right through the various commands or as needed in this demonstration. So the first thing I want to discuss here is the properties tab. The properties tab is where the main parameters for this command reside. So we can enter in the faces that we want to thicken or thin out and so on and so forth. We can click this little X to exit out of the command altogether. Let's go back in. Then we have this little plus sign that gives us access to additional menus if we want to use those. Now, moving all the way to the right, we have our advanced settings menu. So if we click on this, we get a single option, which is single enter to finish command. Now, when this is active or when you see this little check mark next to it, that essentially means that if I hit the enter key, it'll go ahead and execute this command with all of the parameters that are entered and close out of the window all in one step. If we uncheck that, then it will no longer be a single step execution. So that's the only additional option we get in the advanced settings menu. And then, of course, you get your help menu access, which will take you to the Autodesk Inventor help website if you want to utilize that. Moving down, we can actually change the name of the feature on the fly. So to do that, you click on the word thicken and you can enter whatever you want. So I'll just change it to custom and then you hit enter to freeze that change. So when you hit okay, after you've executed your command, you'll see that your feature pops up with the custom name here in the model browser. So it just makes it really easy to track the features that you're adding to the model. Moving over to the right, we have our solid mode, surface mode toggle. So currently we're in solid mode, and you know that because of this little blue cube here in the corner. And let me pick up one face. Currently I have the distance set to an inch. So if I were to hit okay, this would create an inch section here. So it'd thicken that wall by an inch. But let's take a step back and do the surface mode option. So if we select that same face, click this cube to change it to surface mode with this little orange square feature. And hit okay, it will basically offset just a single surface from that original geometry by that distance you specified. So that's the difference between solid mode and surface mode. Moving down, we have our input geometry section. So this is where we actually select the faces we want to use for the thickened or offset features. Okay, so you pick your face of interest. So we'll just pick this one. Okay. And moving over here, we have our quilt selection. So currently it is off. Now, if we toggle this on, we can pick up a series of stitched surfaces. So surfaces that are joined together at the edges. Okay. So I went ahead and created some offset surface features. The first feature consists of both this curve section and this long section. Now, the second feature consists of this one curved segment. Okay. So let's go ahead and toggle our quilt selection on. And when we hover over this one segment, you would expect that it would pick up everything. But remember, a quilt is just stitched together surfaces that are joined at the edges. And in this case, only this corner and this long edge are stitched together here at this edge. Over here, they are two separate entities still. So what we can do to select everything all at once is we can hit cancel, go to surface, stitch, pick up your two segments that you want to stitch together, hit apply. Done. And now when we go back into thicken offset, we can actually select everything all at one time. So when we hover over that, you'll see it picks up everything all at one time. So that is our quilt selection button. The final option in the input geometry section is the automatic phase chain option. So essentially all this does is when we have it toggled on, or when you see this check mark in the box, it automatically chains all tangent faces together with one selection. So rather than going through and selecting all of these faces individually, what I can do is I can instead activate this, hover over the faces of interest, and you'll see that it already selects everything all in one go. And then you can change your parameters as needed and move on from there. So that is a quick way to select a bunch of tangent faces if that's what you're trying to do. On a side note, let's say, for example, you accidentally selected a face that you don't want. All you have to do to deselect it, rather than exiting out of the tool and doing everything all over again, all you have to do is hold the shift key, hover over the face of interest that you want to deselect, and then just left click, and you'll see that it deselects that but maintains everything there. And you see now I have 25 faces rather than 26 in my face selection box. Moving down, we have our behavior section, and this is essentially where we control the direction and the distance of our output. So what we want to do first is select our face of interest. I'll go ahead and just select the single face. Okay. And up here in the direction fields, we can select where we want this to go. We can either move it inside, we can either move it outside, or we can move it centered or mid-plane. So this would add a little bit to the outside and a little bit to the inside. Okay, so let's try the first one. So let's try inside. Okay, and you'll see that it adds that thickness to the inside. Now let's go back and reverse that to something else. We'll go to the outside. You'll see it adds it to the outside. And then lastly, we have the center option. So let's go ahead and click that. And you'll see it adds it a little bit to both. Now it adds more on this side because we're referencing this outer face. If I were to reference this inner face, it would actually lean more towards the inside than the outside. So it really just depends on what your starting face of interest is. Moving to the right, we have our selector style. So if you click this down arrow, you can select either icons or a drop-down menu for these tiles here. So if you click drop-down, you get a little drop-down menu. I prefer icons, so I'm gonna go back to that. And then below that, we can control the distance of our thicken or offset. Okay. And then you have a little arrow to the right. You can pick up and measure a dimension and use that as your parameter for the distance, or you can select a feature dimension itself. So just depending on your design intent, you have plenty of tools there available to you. Moving down, we have automatic blending. So to show you what this does, I went ahead and extruded two cylinders. On the smaller one, I applied a fillet to the sharp edge around the top. And so if we leave this off for now and select this outer face and then offset that, you'll see that it maintains the original shape here in the middle and then expands that sharp edge out as it comes in contact with the cylinder. Now, if we were to go back into that same command and then check automatic blending and hit okay, you'll notice that it expands that rounded edge all the way out and creates that new profile and keeps everything consistent. Next, we have the output section. So this is where we control the Boolean operation for the command. So by default, it's set to join. So like the extrude function and all the other functions that create or remove 3D geometry, this essentially just maintains a single solid body. So any overlapping new geometry over existing geometry, it keeps everything a single solid body. Okay. Next, we have cut. So cut will remove material from our 3D model. Intersect will only maintain the 3D geometry between two various features. And then the last one is new solid. So if we use this, it'll create this new feature as a new solid body. So depending on your design intent, you have plenty of tools here available to you there. Moving down, we have our advanced property section. So this essentially allows us to either allow or disallow approximated outputs for this feature. So if I want it to always arrive in an exact solution or just reject it altogether, if it cannot arrive in an exact solution, I want to uncheck this. But if I have some flexibility and want to allow an approximation if necessary, then I can leave this checked. And when you leave it checked, you have a few different options for the type, and then we could specify our tolerance for that approximated output. We have three main types of approximation. We have never too thin, never too thick, and mean. Never too thin prevents the distance of the offset from falling below our specified value. So if we set 0.1 inches as our value, it will never go below that for the offset. Now, if we go to never too thick, it's the exact opposite. It will never exceed that specified distance. And then mean will fall above and below the specified distance based on a particular tolerance that you have entered into this field. So currently it's set to optimize. We can actually specify the tolerance as well. Optimize essentially just keeps the amount of computational resources down to a minimum to complete the operation. If we want to set our own tolerance, we go to specified, and then we can set our percent tolerance for this mean approximation or one of the other approximations. The last thing I want to talk about is the apply and create new thicken offset button. So that's this little plus sign in the bottom right right-hand corner. Essentially, all this does is it executes the command, but keeps the window open to speed up your workflow and not have to jump in and out of the thicken offset command. So we'll pick a face, set our parameters. This looks fine. Hit the plus sign. It executes that, but keeps the window open. Now, if I were to do that and just hit OK, it closes out of the window altogether. So that's what the apply and create new button does for you. That's all for this segment of the Autodesk Inventor part creation module, where I gave you a detailed overview of the Thicken Offset tool. I really hope that you found this tutorial to be helpful and that you put what you've learned into practice so you can continue developing your skills as you work your way through these lessons. Also, before you watch the next video in the series, make sure you subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications to stay up to date on content that will help you create the future you want for yourself. And of course, don't hesitate to leave a comment or reach out via my website contact page and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on my channel. I really appreciate you choosing to stop by and learn with me, and I'll see you again soon.